I'm Dr. Shashikala Gurpur. My background has been of being a science graduate in natural biological sciences and then doing LLB. After that, I took my LLM from Mysore, then PhD from Mysore. I have been the member of the Law Commission of India. I was fortunate to get the AHRB fellowship to Edinburgh University to look at IP law. Later on, I was a Fulbright scholar as well, being trained in leadership in higher education, apart from many other things that I've done. I occupied this in Symbiosis Law School's directorship and the deanship of the Faculty of Law in 2007. Our college, Symbiosis Law School Pune, is in a way an incubation of new ideas, best practices, and a lot of excellence. Excellence is a natural grain in Symbiosis, coupled with the international outlook. So we have built this difficult discipline of law, which is very, very loyal to nationalistic governance outline, into becoming an internationalized discipline. We are home to universities, intellectual property rights cell, which is first of its kind in India. I think soon after us, or around the same time, Jawaharlal Nehru University got it. Very few universities have IP or innovation cell like us to begin with. So way back in 2012, it was housed in the law school, and I am the chairperson of the cell. Now universities research innovation arm has one head of IP cell who travels on behalf of the cell across 7 faculties and does the actual execution of IP at the level of registration, etc. So that's very unique about our law school. You wouldn't see that in any other law school. We are the first and we are the only law school in the country who engages in actual registration of IP, awareness of IP, although many other law schools have IP cells, IP chairs, and IP blogs, IP policy initiatives, etc. We are a full round kind of institute in terms of legal research. So we consolidated our research wing as Advanced Center for Legal Research called SCALSER, which is a home to very leading 4 European projects. IP talent search examination is very close to our heart because IP examination per se is something that we encourage as one of the career opportunities for our law graduates, especially those in our 3-year LLB who come from engineering and varied backgrounds. You know, we have revived our 3-year program in last 5 years. The other one is, you know, the national patent examination, etc. For that, we wanted to prepare students, and being the IP cell home of the university, we keep doing awareness programs across 7 disciplines. So we use our students also as co-presenters because we believe in research being cascaded as strengthening the ecosystem. So first I received your email. Then when I received the email, I asked our IP cell's important member who has center-staged IP in this law school, being a patent attorney herself, Dr. Rupal Radhesai, who is our face of IP cell across the university and within the college also. She said, why not? Because she herself is a very successful product of this IP search exam. We were receiving an invitation to a globally renowned firm like Ericsson. I mean, that there couldn't be any better recognition for the work that we are doing, or there couldn't be any better opportunity. So we came to know through email, and this is how we went on working about it. It is for us to build that within India, because for one talent that went out, we have 99 talent that remains in India. So we thought this is the way law school can contribute to this mission. As a university, we believe in IP. We were forced to believe because when we went for NAC accreditation and other accreditation, the cutting edge grading point came from those who had some patents. For us, kicking off the first patent from the ground was very, very difficult. And then getting it in such a way that you consolidate it as university achievement. The tendency is people use your facility, they create the substratum for their IP, but then they migrate to some other university and give the privilege there. So forced by this quality, higher cutting edge achievement need, university went for patenting. And university could have entrusted it to some lawyer and the director of the institute. But instead of that, university wanted to consolidate it across all its front-running faculty like engineering, a lawyer with a vision and value and commitment to innovation. So that's the reason why we are interested. And you know, today we have come of age to commercialize our invention. You know, one of our bio-based sanitizers was commercialized. So many methodologies are being tested, protocols are being developed. All these are because of our realization that intellectual property rights and innovation have to be put on a strong pedestal of everybody's engagement. And it has to be institutionalized. It has to start from, the policy has to be so comprehensive, right from the appointment of the employee to the continuation, the commitment to the organization, providing excellent facilities, being accountable to the financial support that they receive, and the ratio of royalty that they receive, the percentage of participation. All these can come only with that comprehensive understanding, which a lawyer is able to drive, or a lawyer leader or manager team can drive. So, that's the reason why university thought it fit. But now we have the IP head who executes. He's more of an executive head who executes it on the ground level. He's fully dedicated to that. Therefore, my earnest request to all your IP initiatives is, please center stage it with law and policy. Without that all-time vision, what we call a strategic approach, a mere understanding of technicality is not sufficient. First of all, yes, Olympiad is catering to that winning urge in students, and that too coming from a winner company, which has got so much innovation to its credit. So it's very meaningful that it is coming from an authentic agency. I would look at this innovation and IP in the positive right sense. I would look at it a better potential of this age group having so many innovative ideas, whether it is a creative field of music or dance or other things, or it can be in the field of, let us say, science, technology, or even business processes. I am seeing the role of this Olympiad even in igniting that idea of acting as a change agent, acting as an awareness hub. In India, we teach it as a theoretical subject. So there's a lot of good that this Olympiad has done. So I'm very happy about it. This award is possible because of the ecosystem from the university, from my very strong team who are already IP experts. The very idea of center staging IP came from my generation of faculty who created a co-curricular cell called Tech Legal Cell. It is a tech legal cell which engages in any IP cell related activity, in popularizing IP, in creating study materials or teaching materials or training materials when we do IP awareness in our sister institutes, or in engaging in real life problem solving like IP clinic for the startups. First of all, we encourage them through their own platform, that is Tech Legal Cell, as I told you, the co-curricular platform. Secondly, Dr. Rupal, who through one of the interns who is a student, came to know about Ms. Chopra, and then through them the conversation happened, and it really worked for us. We have taken a little deviation from Bar Council's optional course to make it a specialization in LLM as well as in undergrad. So a student can take multiple courses in IP in their honors program, and we facilitate those. So we have also, earlier we ran a diploma for those who did not get such opportunity, so those diploma credits could be brought into their main credits. In our sister law school, both in Noida and in Hyderabad, we are encouraging diplomas and masters in IP aside from mandatory course in undergraduate. So this is how, looking at the futuristic dimension, we have encouraged IP. A looking at IP in the business context is something that we teach to students in terms of monetization, taxation, business and IP close relationship. Now that is the most interesting dimension for students, because when it is said business, all different verticals of business opens up as a possibility. For example, I teach biotech and IP. This year I replaced my generic teaching into a bigger module on vaccines. So we need to update. That's how we do. We consult our stakeholders and we look at contemporary developments. If it is not there in the curriculum, we give it as their research assignment, and then we build and we co-publish with the students. This is how we encourage.